是一个双个展，然后两个画家，都是就是有这种，表现主义的倾向，然后，其实都是多少是非裔美国人。那么从布朗说起，其实他是，美国70-80年代，非常活跃的一个画家，然后就是在1988年，成为了第一个，在现在的国博当时的革命博物馆办客展的一个海外艺术家。那么路易斯呢是从2006年就开始在这里设工作室，然后在北京进行了将近10年的创作，然后他的这几组画都是关于物理学、音乐，也包括就是抽象绘画语言本身的一些探索。
This is the exhibition, it's called Booster. It means to make something bigger, grander, more energy, more power, and also the scale. So what I've been doing in China for the last 10 years is actually boosting, making bigger paintings. Painting only comes alive with a spectator. When a person looks at the painting, a conversation happens. I like to think of my work as being very musical, and so,There's also a level of spirituality. I'm playing with the idea of Buddha, the spiritual Buddha. He was also a monk. And I'm thinking about Thelonious Monk and a conversation between these two great people. And I always thought they would like each other. Frederick Brown is an American artist, a great painter. He was really the first one who was given the opportunity.To have a one-man show, what is called now the National Museum of China, on Tiananmen Square. So in 1988, about 1 million people saw this exhibition. It was really a very important show for China. Fred Brown was a personal friend of mine, so I thought it was my duty and responsibility and friendship and humanity to remind China of this great man who brought this great exhibition.
这回事儿，直到这个刘维斯告诉过我，然后我开始讨论，就是这些，就是在这个，比如说，最主流的这个关于80年代的这个叙事之外的，有某一些有意思的东西，他们的作品上也有一定的共鸣，所以就觉得放到一起，然后就是也代表了就是，两种不同的时刻，以及这些时刻所。涵盖的一种文化和文化交流的一种模式。
We are all human beings absorbing information. We're being built by experiences when we see people. My job is just to make the paintings from my experiences. And when the paintings come into the world, they stand on their own. That's just how the world is. That's it.Deal with it. That's jazz, baby.